National Weather Service out of Dutch City, Kansas, has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for Ness County, Southern Trigo County, Northwestern Pawnee County, Western Rush County, and Southwestern Ellis County until 10:30 p.m. and 9:33 p.m. A severe thunderstorm was located near Cedar Bluff, moving south at 35 miles per hour. Hazards are ping pong ball size hail and 60-mile-per-hour wind gusts. Locations impacted include Ness City, Bazine, Ransom, McCracken, Alexander, Brownwell, Cedar Bluff, Hargrave, and Arnold. Trio County dispatch concluding at 21:34.
Hey everybody, welcome. So I'm back out here in Kansas. Things are firing up. Firing up. So right now I'm just east of Ness City in Kansas, watching this supercell come down. As I do, there are storms popping up all over. So the storm I'm watching, I'll give you an idea. So I'm right there in Ness City. I'm watching this big hailer coming down just northeast of Ransom. Got some rotation in there, as you can see. But just ahead of it, I'm watching all these little pop-ups. It was by itself, but everything's kind of filling in. It's going to be one big old giant blob. Yeah. It's a nice line of thunderstorms. I'm trying to avoid any of that gorilla hail. I don't need baseballs and stuff like that. I can manage some of the smaller stuff. Definitely a lot of hail in all these storms.
There's one over here now. I got a lot of lowering over here. It's going to be along the county line, maybe further north than that, but I'm watching it right now.
So there's a deputy watching a lowering somewhere. I didn't catch where he was, but I see some lowering myself here and there. Hey, Becca.
10-6, Liberal Office.
Happy birthday.
Watch what I bring you.
I know you don't want me to say that.
He's telling me now from Dodge that we're going to start seeing more straight line winds with this kind of moving a little more to the east and coming more over the lake now, so the wind should pick up.
Yeah, well, appreciate that.
With these storms here today in Kansas, it's more of a light show.
This is a fairly decent wind.
It's more of a light show and a lot of hail. There's always that chance of an isolated tornado, but there's really not a big chance for tornadoes with this. It's going to be a marathon here for the next probably 4 to 5 days. I'll be all over the place. Kansas, Oklahoma, Texas. So, yeah, I'll be on a marathon. Yeah. Definitely a big gust front approaching with this. I can already smell the dirt in the air. So yeah, the main threat with this, lightning, hail, and very strong winds. In rain, yeah.
Okay. Ness 83.
Yeah. With all these storms bubbling up together, there's definitely that flooding threat too. So I know people don't pay too much attention to the flooding aspect of all this. It's just as dangerous. Yeah, the tornado threat with these storms is really low. Never know, one could pop out. You know, last Saturday when I was in Salina, had that late tornado warning. I don't think anything ever hit the ground, but it's always a possibility. I mean, we are in Kansas, you know.
Thank you.
Yeah, I put my starting point in the details of the live stream, but if you're just now joining, I am, just east of Ness City, just outside the city here in Kansas. I think this is 96 I'm on. Yeah, 96, Highway 96, or State Road 96, whatever you want to call it.
To 10 miles south of Alameda to 7 miles south of Friend, moving southeast to 35 miles per hour. Hazards are 60 miles per hour wind gusts and quarter size hail. Severe thunderstorms will be near Utica and Arnold around 9:50 p.m. Trio County Dispatch concluding at 2146.
Looks like a tickle deputies out myself. I think we'll be okay for now, but I think we can get a lot of rain. Looks like those are all coming together right over us, maybe.
Yeah, there's definitely plenty of lightning. Feel that gust front hitting. Yeah, and I can check. I don't think there is, but let me look. I don't think there's any active. No, everything's just severe thunderstorm warnings right now. There's no active tornado warnings. As far as I know, there hasn't been any
no power in
tornado warnings. So I'll give you a look at the radar now, what it's looking like. So there I am in Ness City, just south of Ransom, waiting on that line to come to me with all that hail. I'm watching that hail, make sure it's not going to be something that takes out my windshield. Windshields are like $400.
Thank you.
Your mic, I can hardly hear you.
10-4.
So, this thing has some pretty good size hail in it. I want to make sure I'm not in that good size hail. So I may move here to the west a little bit, back towards into the city there. Find me a car wash.
I wonder if they got a car wash.
83, was that you that just passed me? Go ahead and hang out at the Laird elevators and kind of watch this hang in.
10-4.
I think Reed's out here tonight. I think he's still at home. I'm not sure what his plan is, but I'm thinking he... will probably be out the Sunday, Monday, chasing.
Down 96 back towards the city there. West more.
I got a lot of rain right now. Really all I can see is rain and lightning. That's it. I've been watching on the radar on the phone, but it's not that good a radar.
10-4. Yeah, it looks like it's starting to disappear now.
I think it's that.
about, oh shit, up there by K4. Might even be just south of K4.
Yeah, that's what the biggest part of that cell was, and that hail core was probably just crossing over K4 here. Weakened out quite a bit. There's still a pretty good hail core north of Brown Elliott. Yeah, good part. I've got literally nothing here in Ness other than lightning. Back east into it, kind of tail along, see what I see. That
over in the Arnold area, indicating that there were low level clouds dropping down. Looked like they were headed from Crego County towards Ransom. I assume you're in that area anyway, so you might check it out.
80s, I'm at K96 and J Road, and I can see those low level clouds. They are in fact heading east.
Ten four, 2158.
89
I'll be out
of Western for sure. 10-4, 2158. 84 I'm right here beside those clouds. Watching them go over right now.
10-4, 2159.
K4 and T-Tom.
This is an Austin County and all listing stations. Please stand by for 1067. 1067 is a 1013 update out of Bazine City. At 9:58 p.m., some heavy lightning severe thunderstorms were located along a extending 7 miles south of Arnold to 13 miles south of Beeler to 9 miles north of Garden City, moving southeast at 35 miles per hour, 70 miles per hour wind gusts, and quarter-sized hail. Cautionary including 2159.
K-164, could you swing by the EMS barn?
So I'm going to move east from here towards Alexander.
Gallons 13.9, mileage 87296.
There's a bit of an area of rotation to the east of me.
22.
Between here, Ness City and Bazine.
Should I go back down and get fuel?
The county is kind of moving southeast. That's pretty good though. That go in it. There's a lot of wind and it crosses into Pawnee County and it hits those big woods and lines and pulls them down and black us out. You might want to be full.
A lot of lightning, the wind's just starting to pick up a little bit. wasn't bad though.
Yeah, it's storming up north, but I guess it's got wind in it. By radar anyway. Florida Craig.
A severe thunderstorm warning remains in effect until 10:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time for Northwestern and Wellsford counties. At 10:06 p.m. Central Daylight Time, severe thunderstorms are located along a line extending from near Ness City to 13 miles northeast of Calvesta to 9 miles northeast of Bergen City, moving southeast at 35 miles per hour. 70 miles per hour wind gust.
Pretty decent hail cell over by Brownell.
2209.
Sorry if anybody's trying to talk to me. I'm not paying attention to the chat right now.
2211.
I'm paying attention to the wall there.
Heavy rain, little to no visibility.
And it looks like it's just about to start hitting us.
I am a mile west of Ness City on 96. We have very high winds and zero visibility from the rain.
2212.
Big chamber there.
Personnel, get fuel in the deli.
Yeah, it was moving more east, but the more it moves, I'm looking at it right now, it's moving more south, so it might clip the northeast part of our county, so at least have you in that direction.
2-4.
I'm about 6 miles west of Bazine. So what I'm looking at, and I'll show you guys real quick too. I don't know how the live feed's doing. But. So you see Bazine, you see this coming down. There's an area of rotation right there. There's also a little bit of a hook right there in Ness City. So, definitely a lot going on with this storm. Yeah, get back in there.
I have a motorist that is stuck in a ditch. on Old 40, just west of 180th Avenue, and it is a GMC Terrain. She has told me that she has contacted her insurance company and spoke with someone at R&R, and they could not give her an ETA at this point. I will give R&R a call and see how long it's going to be for them.
Yeah.
G16.
Hey, this storm is changing shape rapidly. You see how it comes down as a line, and now it's kind of echoing out there. It kind of puts me in a spot. Bazine.
P-size hail,
I can handle that. sit where I was sitting because it's all rain coming in behind me from the west. And can't see nothing that way, so like that one deputy said, it was just blinding. Zero visibility. Get down here in Bazine and then see where I want to go from there. May go south a little bit towards Burdett. Big hail falling, hide. If you can't get under anything, the best thing you can do is just pull over and stop and hope for the best. As long as you keep moving, that just creates more of an impact with that hail on your windshield.
The National Weather Service from Dodge City was issued a severe thunderstorm warning for Haviland County until 11:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 10:24 p.m., severe thunderstorms were located along a line extending from near the crack into 15 miles south of Amy, moving south at 45 miles per hour, heavy mile per hour wind gusts and quarter size scale. Haviland County, 22:25.
Yes, I called that one.
Stop around over road here.
How about you go and stop? We'll stage you up at that old gas station there in Kinsley.
Kern City Station 57-1013 for two thunderstorm warnings. First warning, National Weather Service in Dodge City issued a severe thunderstorm warning for northeastern Finney, Death, Hodgman, Southern Lane, and northeastern Gray until 23:15 hours. Repeating, National Weather Service in Dodge City issued a severe thunderstorm warning for northeastern Finney, Death, Hodgman, Southern Lane, northeastern Gray until 23:15 at 22:24. Severe thunderstorms are located along the line extending from near McCracken to 15 miles south of Amy. Moving south at 40 miles per hour, and right for a second, woman.
Repeating rhythm, Northwest County, until 23:30 hours. Repeating National Weather Service in that city, this is the Arizona for morning for Pawnee Rush, Northwestern Edwards County until 23:30 hours. At 22:26, severe thunderstorms are located along the line extending from near McCracken to near Albert, moving south at 35 miles an hour. 1064,
2028. I'm going to still send you to that location. If it comes up, I'll pull you off of that one since he's out too.
North of the gas station, so I can see an opening.
I'm looking back to my west. I'm just, I'm in the Bazine, Kansas. And so I'm looking back to my west towards what shows to be an area of circulation.
26 9 23
Well, that's a good thing. I see a little bit of pea to marble size. I think I'm staying out ahead of it right now. That one, but that was a hell of a strike. Right out my driver window.
Three.
Right now, I'm east on 96. East of Alexander, coming up on, what is that, Nacoma? So I'm trying to get to 183 Rush Center and go south on 183 and head this thing off down around Brazil.
Just report of a 47 U-56, 2 miles west of the west. The MI cattle truck and a pickup truck pulling a horse trailer.
U-56 Chrome City, I'll be in route.
U-56 Stanfield, 1345.
Did you say 1047?
Dodge City, but those storms coming out of Colorado were taking their sweet time. Nothing significant was developing west of Dodge City. This storm had been going for a while, so I shot up north to catch it.
6 to you, public service communications, please.
Sorry about that. Had to mute it. So I'm in Rush Center, Kansas right now on 96. I'm going to go south on 183. As this thing starts to line out, I'll show you guys real quick the radar. So, where am I? Yeah. So on your upper right corner is Rush Center. That's where I am. I'm going to go south on 183 as these storms start to line out a little bit. And catch it down that ways. McCracken. What's a McCracken? We're heading south. Probably won't see as much lightning or anything, but I want to get down a little bit and then watch the wall for the wind again. There are some areas of circulation as this thing starts to make more of a line, a north, a more southwest to northeast kind of a line. Out of this range in a few minutes. I this next week is going to be busy. I'll be out every day chasing somewhere. Somewhere between Kansas, Oklahoma, and Texas. Probably spend a lot of time in Texas. I think that's going to be a hot spot. Northern Texas, Panhandle, east of Lubbock area. Probably look this Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, maybe into Wednesday. Be a lot of chasing going on. Preferably more daytime. So you can actually see some. See it off to my west.
23. And can you note the weather? Because the one's 23.
Yep.
Unseen and I'm 10:24.
82, go ahead.
I have to watch out for deer out here as well. Lots of deer.
Thank you.
47, Mary David Union.
Alright, so you guys have an idea where we are. We are right there at
Holly.
I stopped here for a moment just to take a look. But I think I'm going to go more towards Kinsley right now on 50.
This is 2316.
Thank you.
Storm Chaser is going to come on my channel and call someone else fake? Get out of here.
Two
Greensburg County Station, all seen at the listening station, 1057, first item for rebroadcast. 10 Lincoln Boulevard, Kinsley, Greensburg, 2012, still reported escape, 2012, Bill 46, 2012, Greensburg, 2012, Bill 46, 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 2012, Bill 46
Continuing second item for rebroadcast, Marshall County Sheriff's Office, been on lookout for a stolen trailer. Out of Marshall County, bias is a black, homemade gooseneck car trailer.
This bad boy. Ride it out.
And 13 update, National Weather Service advisory for southwestern Ellsworth County, northwestern Rice County, in Martin County in Central Kansas, 11:23 hours, National Weather Service. Correction, 11:23 p.m., National Weather Service is tracking a strong thunderstorm along the line, descending from Geneseo to Bowman. Isaac confirms for nearly stationary hail at the size of 9 to the death. The back of Great Bend, Pleasanton, Elwood, Claflin, Bowman, Galatia, Tuesday, and Elwood. Well,
us up. Get over here to Kinsley and hold up and watch this thing pass through. It's pretty intense. There's a little bit of circulation in there. Got some hail going on. Ride it out. going to get on the other side of Kinsley where it's dark, so watch this thing roll through. It's got two areas of circulation. This is the storm we're looking at. We're in Kinsley, just on the west side of town. And so that's the storm we're looking at rolling in on us. You can see three areas of circulation, so there's a lot of moving parts with this storm. Ain't gonna be no tornadoes, I don't think, but might get exciting.
It may have been less than that.
Interesting spot, just west of off road. Let me look at something.
There's cars coming from that conference up there. Odds tonight.
I have to say, this streaming phone that I use is extremely helpful in looking at the wall cloud with the lightning. I can see it so much better than with my own eyes, looking out the window.
14, your Kansas 28, 463, Larry Adams X-ray, returned on it 2010, Chevrolet Tahoe, to a head booth, Benyez out of Lewis, to Brian Finn, a 2021, and it's me, and I'm just clear.
Respond to EMS, City Fire, respond rescue, 211-01, number 8, chest 2354.
Avenue for 32-year-old male, copy three male ID, County Trustee, who's from Liberty.
Okay.
felt that. I didn't just hear it. I felt it. Skin got you here. Oh, that's cool. Shout out to Damon for getting you here.
looking up. All looking up. These streets are toast. They're just flooded. I got to drive down the middle of the road just to stay out of the water. River going across the road here. Wow, crazy flooding. Hey John, how's it going? Yeah, it's a pretty good light show tonight.
Someone walking, couple miles east of the B-19 spur, walking eastbound Evan Rock. Good one.
No tornadoes that I know of. I never saw any warnings come out anywhere. At least not up here in Kansas. I don't think anywhere, actually. There wasn't a high probability for tornadoes today anyway. That probability will go up. Get more enhanced, Chris. Lots of water.
We're out to Western Plains. The one, go Green Station, GMI 0.
Long, lonely road this is.
high hydrogen. Can I see you go all the way down to 50th Avenue? Not seeing anybody. I'll head back to Greensburg. Still check.
Appreciate it.
had a good communications. Rock, Western Plains, any mileage, 2.6.
County to Bazine.
Greensburg. Highway 400 coming up. Greensburg? What's in Greensburg worth touring?
I don't know nothing about it. Been to it a couple times.
256 from City.
Y'all can see this
right
now. You don't see that train?
It's in 52-005.
Racing the train.
005-765.
10-4, thank you.
47.
car on.
Thank you. vehicle too is going to be removed by the owners.
I gotta show you guys this before we, in case nobody's ever seen it. Let me do this illegal U-turn here. While we're in Pratt, might as well. Is this it here? Nope.
in it? I think they see it.
It's a brick road, it's not a yellow brick road though. Man, where is that? I know it ain't down here. Maybe they ain't got lights on. It's not lit up. Should have that sign lit up. It would look cool. Anyway, it's called the Hotel Paris. And it's got a big old neon sign on the top, on the roof. They just don't have it on. I thought it'd look cool at night, but I've only seen it in the daytime. I guess it doesn't work. Paris and Kansas. I wonder if there's any relation to the Hilton. All right, everybody, I'm going to take a break here for a while and I'm gonna gas up, and then I'll head home. Appreciate everybody joining. I'll be out all weekend, Monday, Tuesday. It'll be like a 4 or 5 day marathon. I'll probably be down in Texas quite a bit. And the kids are out playing. So everybody have a good night. I appreciate it. We'll see y'all on the next live. A nice lightning strike. I see it. Somebody left some donations. I appreciate it. I don't know who did it, but I appreciate all the donations. Thank you very much. It helps with gas and other expenses. So, y'all take care. We'll see you next time. Stay safe.